Hey everyone, welcome to the second installment in my brand new to Blender course, which is pretty much just an introduction to what Blender is, and talking a little bit about what you as an artist might want to do with the software, and the different types of things that you can do with it, and of course, how the best way to go about achieving your goals and learning the software. So today we're going to be talking about what you would like to do with the software, now we know what it is. And to do that, I'm just going to talk you through the different types of things we can do inside of Blender and which one of these might sound appealing to you. If you don't know what Blender is, in the last episode, I talked about why it's one of the most awesome free softwares ever. So first of all, everything in Blender starts off with a 3D model. And for that reason, a lot of beginners like to start here. There are two main ways to model in Blender. You can model either hard surface objects, which are objects that are fairly rigid and don't move much. This would be, for example, your props in an animation or a game. And then of course you have your organic or soft surface modeling, which is more for things that move, such as characters, animals, or maybe something like clothing, for example. These soft surface models are usually animated in the world of 3D, but they don't necessarily have to be. Of course, you can do both types of modeling, but usually a lot of people like to focus and specialize in just one area. So it's totally up to you whether or not you want to learn both skills, or if you just want to focus in one particular area. But I, of course, would encourage you to learn both if that's what you want to do, as why not make the most of the freedom of this free software? Awesome, so that's 3D modeling. Next, we have rigging and skinning / weight painting. So rigging is the process of creating something called a rig or an armature in 3D, which will eventually have the ability to move and animate a model, such as a character, for example. So rigging is the process of creating this animatable skeleton, if you like, but we still have to attach this rig to our character or model. And that's where a process called skinning or weight painting comes in. I know skinning is quite a harsh sounding word, but it's essentially just using a paint tool inside a Blender to attach our model to our rig. So when the rig moves, the model will move with it. And the reason why it's known as weight painting is because you're going to have a different weight for different parts of your model to control how much maybe a certain bone of your skeleton or armature influences a certain part of your model as the armature or rig moves. Then that brings us on nicely to 3D animation. This is the skill of actually making awesome 3D animations, either for an animation project or for a game. 3D animators don't necessarily need to make their own 3D models and rigs, but a lot of Blender users like to go down that route and create everything themselves. So it's totally up to you, but don't feel like you have to go ahead and 3D model and rig everything, as you can easily just learn to animate on its own using some free modeled rigs on the internet. There's also cool generator tools you can use as well, such as Vroid Studio, which allows you to create anime characters with rigs already attached to them for free. We also have 3D art or 3D renders, which is where you compose a nice image using 3D elements such as 3D models, rigs to pose, and of course lights to light up your scene. This is usually just a single image though, when we say 3D art or 3D renders, but some people in the community do make some like maybe shorter animations, and they would call that a 3D artwork or something. But when we talk about 3D animation, we're usually more referring to just the process of animating on its own. Again, just like with 3D animation, you can use either your own models that you've made, or you can download some ones which are free or paid from the internet, and you can just create some nice renders or 3D artwork using those. However, a lot of Blender users, including myself, do prefer to kind of create the models themselves and then create a render. But it really comes down to what part of 3D you in particular enjoy. As after all, the only reason we're doing this in the first place is maybe because we're creative people and we want to do something we're passionate about. Sometimes though, finding out what you actually enjoy will just come down to trying out a few things in the beginning and trying to see which one you feel like you enjoy the most. So don't be too afraid to go ahead and just experiment with a bunch of different things in Blender and see which one you like. But yeah, that covers some of the awesome things we can do with Blender. In the next installment of this mini course, I'm going to show you how to download Blender and what you need to know about different Blender versions. If you're watching this on YouTube the day this video has been posted, you'll find that the next installment in this mini course should be releasing tomorrow. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.